Hi techies, today I'm going to explain a few Informatica interview questions and answers. First one is explain the difference between mapping parameter and mapping variable. And second one is how can you validate all mappings in the repository simultaneously. And third question is what is surrogate key. And fourth question is what is target load order. And fifth one is what is event weight task. And sixth one is, can one use mapping parameter or variables created in one mapping into any other reusable transformation? And seventh one is, how can one identify whether mapping is correct or not without connecting session? First we'll see what is the difference between the mapping parameter and mapping variable. When value changes during the session execution, it's called as mapping variable. Upon completion of session execution, the Informatica server stores the end value of variable and it is reused when the session restarts. Values that do not change during the session execution are called mapping parameters. Values are allocated to these parameters before starting the session. The second question is, how can you validate all mappings in the repository simultaneously? The answer is, all the mappings cannot be validated simultaneously because each time only one mapping can be validated. The third question is, what is surrogate key? Surrogate keys are typically meaningless integers used to connect the fact to the dimension tables of a data warehouse. Surrogate key is a replacement for the natural prime key. It is a unique identification for each row in the table. It is very beneficial because the natural prime key can change, which eventually makes update more difficult. In Informatica, the simplest and most preferred way to generate surrogate key is using sequence generator transformation. We can also create a sequence in the database and use the same to generate the S case for any table. This can be invoked by a SQL transformation or using a stored procedure transformation. The next question is, what is target load order? If you have multiple source qualifier transformations connected to the multiple targets, you can specify the order in which the integration service loads the data into the targets using target load plan option. This will give you an option to control which target load order group needs to be executed first and load to the target. One of the limitations with this target load plan is that even if any of the target load order group is failed, we cannot restart the session from the fail step. We have to start again from the beginning. The fifth question is, what is event wait task? The event wait task waits for a predefined event or a user defined event. A predefined event is a file watch event. When you use the event wait task to wait for a predefined event, you specify an indicator file for the integration service to watch. The integration service waits for the indicator file to appear. Once the indicator file appears, the integration service continues running tasks after the event wait task. The sixth question is, can one use mapping parameter or variables created in one mapping into any other reusable transformation? Yes, we can use, because reusable transformation does not contain any maplet or mapping. The next question is, how can one identify whether mapping is correct or not without connecting session? One can find whether the session is correct or not without connecting the session is with the help of debugging option.